Hi everybody, Aaron here. Today I'm going to do a tag. And the tag I'm going to do today is called Reading My Country Tag. And it is actually made by a girl named Cook Read Create on BookTube, and she asked me if I wanted to do this tag. So I am. And I'll link her original video down below, and so you can check it out if you want to. And it's 9 questions that I'm going to ask. Answer today. Question number 1 is, what country are you going to talk about? And since I come from Sweden, of course I'm going to talk about Sweden. And now we have question number 2, which is, what is your favorite childhood book from your country? And if you don't have one, name a popular children's book from your country. And when I was little, I didn't really read like Swedish books. I mean, I read them in Swedish, of course, but since I was little, I didn't know English back then. But they were all like translated to Swedish, so they weren't like, you know, translated. They were not originally written in Swedish. And my favorite series when I was little was Harry Potter by J.K. Rowling, but I mean, she's from the UK, so yeah. But I don't really know if I had a favorite book from a Swedish author, but when I was little I did like ABC-resan by Elsa Beskow. I did read that a lot, but that's quite for young children, and it's actually quite old. I think it's from 1945 or something like that, but yeah, I did like that one. So I guess that will be the answer to this question, since I didn't really read books that originally was written from in Swedish. I think I read some that was originally Norwegian or something like that. So, I mean, I was in Scandinavia a little bit, at least. And then we come to question number 3, and that question is, what is a book from your country that you read in school? Primary school or high school? Your choice. And when I was in, I think it was 5th grade or something like that, we had to read People Long Stocking by Astrid Lindgren. And, I mean, when you go in 5th grade in Sweden, you're 11 years old. And I thought that I was, like, I don't know, too old for that book. I never really liked People Long Stocking, not even when I was little. And also I thought I was too old for it at that time, so I didn't really like it that much. But I mean, she's quite the character, because, well, she's the world's strongest girl and everything like that. But yeah, that one I read in school. I actually read it in when I was in university too, because we had to read it for one of my classes, so I read it twice for school. Now we have question number 4, which is, what is a book set in your favorite area of your country, and or what's a book set in a place you'd like to visit in your country? So I don't actually have this book on me, because it's my mother's and I just borrowed it for a course in school in university. That's like my answer to everything, I feel like. But I read Mig äger ingen by Åsa Linderborg, I think her name is, yes. And that one takes place in Västerås in Sweden. And that's actually where I was born. And I lived there until I was gone like 2 months before I turned 10. So I've lived there for a couple of years. But now technically I've lived longer where I live now, because I lived there for 12 years. But yeah, Västerås is definitely one of my favorite places, even though I haven't been there for like, I don't know, a couple of years. Did visit a lot in the beginning, but not so much anymore. Question number 5, what is an historical fiction book set in your country? I don't really read a lot of historical fiction, not in general, but definitely not Swedish historical fiction, so I could only come up with one book that I actually, you know, counted in that question like area, and that was I mjölnarens spår by Stina Nilsson Bassell. And this one takes place in 1895, and it's called Emma is supposed to get married with this farmer, really, and then we also get to be part of 1936, when Emma is a little bit older and stuff like that. So yeah, that's the only historical fiction I've read that takes place in Sweden. And now we have question number 6, which is, what is a book by an ingenious author from your country? And if this is not applicable to your country, skip it. And I mean, in Sweden it is Samerna. I don't even know what the English word is for that, that will like hear first. But I haven't ever actually read a book written by someone that is Sama. I wish I had, because that sounds really, really cool. because they had it kind of tough. But yeah, I'd really like to read one, but haven't, so guess we're moving on then. And then question number seven, what is a classic book from your country? And I don't really know, like, books. I'm really bad at Swedish books in general. Like, I have, like, no, I don't know anything. So I've gone more for author rather than how popular the books themselves are. But I'd say Selma Lagerlöf, and this one contains Lövenskiöldskrinen, Charlotte Lövenskiöld, and Annas Svärd. So I don't know, I have no idea like how popular these three books are, but Selma Lagerlöf is definitely one Swede that every Swede knows about, no matter if they have actually read anything by her or not. Everybody knows the name, you know. So I definitely count her as one of the big like classic authors that are really popular. And question number eight, what is a book from your country that you haven't read but would like to read? For this question, I would say Saken ingen ser by Anna Ahlund, because I did read Du bara by her, I think it was last year, and she always have like LGBTQ characters, which I really like, of course, and her characters are always like really amazing. It's well written, everything. So I really do want to read Saken ingen ser, but I haven't yet, and it's been out since the middle of August, so I definitely have to get on that. But yeah, that's definitely one book I want to read in Swedish. I don't read a lot of Swedish books, to be honest. That's one that I've been looking for, definitely. And then question number nine, which is the last question, is what are some of your favorite authors or books from your country? And like I said, I don't read a lot of Swedish authors. I don't really read a lot of books in Swedish at all. Not anymore. I used to a lot, but not anymore. But I do have like two authors that comes to mind, and one of them is Mats Strandberg, and this is Färjan, or The Blood Cruise, I think it's called in English. You should totally check him out. But yeah, I really love his books, and he's one of the authors that co-wrote Englisfors trilogin, which are also out in English actually. And I really loved that when I was like 13 or something like that, and then I read this one 2015, I believe it was. Loved it, and I'm currently reading Hemet by him, so he's definitely one of these Swedish authors where I try to read all of his books. He has done some children's books as well that I really want to check out, because I love reading children's books, and I'm studying to become a kindergarten teacher, so I need to read that jazz. But yeah, he's definitely one of them. And the other one you might know as well, because he's also have books that have been translated into English. I mean, those authors are like a little bit more international than a lot of the others are. But this is Fredrik Backman, and this one is Vi mot er. This book actually came out in the end of August, I want to say. I think it was 21st. So it hasn't come out in English yet, but book one is called Beer Town. It's out in English, and this is, I think it's going to be a trilogy, I'm not sure. But it's so good and so amazing, and I love it. And I actually met Fredrik Backman a couple of weeks ago, and he's so funny. And yeah, definitely, I have only read two books by him, to be honest. I do own another one, but I haven't read it yet, and I'm ashamed to say that. But he is definitely one of the authors where I'm trying to like collect all of his books and read them, because I need to do so. And yeah, those were some of my favorites and the books I've read and everything like that. I hope you like this video where it's more focused on like my Swedish roots or whatever you want to call it. Because if you do, please let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to think of some more videos where I talk about like Swedish books or whatever. I do have a video of Swedish covers versus the UK and the US ones, and if you're interested in that, I will link that down below as well. But yeah, if you like this video, please give me some thumbs up, and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel by clicking the little button down below. And yeah, I hope we see each other next time. Bye.